Now to the music industry murders that have created a global mystery. If you were around in the late 1990s, I wasn't born yet, you'll remember how rappers Tupac and Biggie were murdered by gunmen just months apart. Our next guest led a task force to uncover the truth on who killed them, and his search was made into the recent Netflix series Unsolved. It's incredible. Take a look.
What do you know about the Christopher Wallace murder?
Biggie?
You're going to find out who really killed the Notorious B.I.G.
They're pulling me onto another task force. It's a cold case. I want you to join me. What's the case? Biggie Small.
Get down on your knees!
There is a very real possibility that the murder of Biggie Smalls is directly related to the murder of Tupac.
This case is legendary, and I want to be the cop that was finally able to help solve it.
Wow. Oh, please, yeah. Welcome to Studio 10, the former LAPD detective who wanted to solve this case, Greg Kading. Good morning, yeah. Greg.
Good morning.
So that was you.
That was me, yes. Yeah. Can't you tell?
I love it. I love it.
Did you have a say in the casting?
No, but had I had a say, that's what I
picked. That would have been
successful. Yeah. Yeah. My wife would have made me pick him.
Yeah. Now, Greg, let's start with Tupac's death in Vegas in 1996. Yeah. Now, he was a huge music star. How did it happen, and do you reckon it was gang-related?
Yeah, he was on top of the world. He is out there celebrating with his CEO, Suge Knight, of Death Row Records. They're having a great time. He's with Mike Tyson, who was a friend of his, who's fighting that night. He's on top of the world. And he gets into a fight with a guy in the lobby of the casino, and that leads to a payback by a gang member. So it really, even though there's all these conspiracy theories, it just comes down to this conflict that took place between these individuals and the gangs.
We've just been talking, Merrick and I were, like, you know, this is like our, you know, where were you when JFK got shot kind of moment. Like, it was just such huge news. And like, what, these rappers are actually going around just shooting, killing each other. Was it music related? Was it his boss at Death Row Records, clues in the name, Suge Knight? Was it a Bloods and Crips thing? What was behind this?
Ultimately, it was a variety of things. There was, you know, a big conflict going on between Puffy Combs and Suge Knight, the record heads. And then, of course, the artists, Puffy and Biggie. I'm sorry, Biggie and Tupac were having a big, you know, squabble. And then the gangs that they were affiliated with. And once the violence started, it just kept getting worse until it resulted in murder.
Wow.
Now, the rap world was still coming to terms with losing Tupac when Biggie Smalls was killed in early 97.
That's right.
Were they linked? That's, you know, the what everyone said forever.
Absolutely. One led to the other.
Right. How? Mm-hmm.
Well, it was a retaliation. Suge Knight hired a guy to go out and kill Biggie Smalls in retaliation for losing Tupac in Vegas. So it was all gang-related warfare. But there was all these other kind of nuances and dynamics that played and fed into it.
But what about, like, the conspiracy theories? Because there's so many conspiracy theories about, particularly in particular Tupac, that he's actually living in Cuba.
Yeah.
And that he's not dead at all. And because I think his body was cremated so quickly after his murder as well. So is there any, did you have to investigate those kind of more wild rumors or suspicions?
Absolutely. We treated every theory as if it could be true.
So did you go to Cuba? Because it's a great excuse to go to Cuba.
Yeah, I searched all the beaches. Yeah. I couldn't find him.
Wasn't it? Sorry,
he
guys.
He wasn't there to be found. I did find Elvis, though.
Yeah.
No, of course, these conspiracy theories are like all conspiracy theories. If you take selective information, you can build a theory and then begin to support it. But, you know, you have to do a comprehensive analysis of the facts and the evidence, and that should lead you to a definitive conclusion, which it did in our case.
Do you think that Biggie Smalls actually did have a hand in Tupac Shakur's death, that he ordered it, or he was just a member of a rival thing when it happened and that's why he got...
He had no direct involvement. You know, right. Biggie's innocent of any of that, but he did have some indirect involvement because of the war that was going on between the record labels.
Right.
So, you know, the lyrics, if you listen to some of these lyrics and they're dissing each other, all of that played into it and fueled the fire.
But, you know, Katy Perry and Taylor Swift diss each other in their lyrics, and it doesn't come down to this.
They dress up as fast food and
Well, Katy Perry, they don't associate with gangs, I'm assuming.
Right.
And when
I
you bring...
probably right.
When they bring that element into it, you don't know what to expect. Mm. You know, these are gangs from Compton, you know, that have... That's what they do.
Mm.
And once that rivalry turned into a dependency on the protection provided by these gangs, then...
There was some talk of police corruption, too. What were your thoughts on that, given you were in the LAPD?
Yeah, Insofar as the corruption, as far as being involved, absolutely not. You know, we exonerated all of those allegations, uh-huh. but there was still a lot of incompetence.
Right.
And there was, we could have done a much better job in the early investigations. So that's what we had to come back and try to correct years later.
People are astounded that these murders are still basically unsolved and that two such huge stars could be shot down right in broad daylight, effectively, and not be solved. Are they just really high-profile examples of the kind of gang murders that go on in LA all the time that also, I guess, never get solved?
Great question, and 100%. About 60 to 70% of all gang crimes, gang-related homicides in Los Angeles go unsolved.
Really?
Wow. Oh, yeah, absolutely. And it's because of that subculture of the gangs where they don't cooperate with law enforcement.
Yeah, right.
So they're not providing you any of the details or the information that you need to move forward. And that was the case in both of these murders. Nobody was cooperating.
So, Greg, why should we care about this? Why do you think it's important for all of us to know about these deaths and who's responsible?
Well, these individuals are iconic, you know, people in the music industry. And in their culture and in their genre of music, they're legendary. Mm. And I think history is very important. And setting history straight insofar as what happened to these men, we have a responsibility to do that when we have the information to provide.
Does this sort of vitriol and so forth still exist there? Is there a danger that something like this could happen again?
It's still happening. Yeah, it's not at this level because of how large these guys were. But absolutely, within that rap gang culture, this stuff's still going on. People are still being shot and killed.
It is a fascinating chat, and you can catch Greg at special speaking events in Sydney this Wednesday night, then Adelaide and Perth this weekend. You can head to austix.com.au for all the details and tickets. Fascinating chat, Greg. Thank you so much.
Thanks for having me.
Much appreciated. Thank you.